Hello and welcome to a new 3CX tutorial. When using 3CX, you need to create extensions, set voicemails or recordings, and this information has to be stored in a backup. This is what we are going to see today. After you log into the 3CX management console, let's head to the backup and restore option located in the main menu on the left part of your screen. You will find many options there. As you can see, there is a backup that has already been done. Here, we can see different aspects such as name of the file, creation date, size of the backup file, version of the console. This information is about the file created after a backup. Whenever you want to create a backup, you need to click on the Add Backup button. After this, you will see a window with the following options. Backup name, this is the name of the backup file. After this, you will find what kind of information is going to be stored in your backup, having in mind that the information regarding the system configuration is going to be included. You have to choose between the following options to add to your backup: license key information, custom templates, logos, firmwares, faxes, voicemails, recordings. Backup and restore will take longer. To finish the process, you can choose to enter a password to encrypt this backup for security reasons. Then, you need to click on the OK button, and you are going to have a backup on demand. If you want to schedule a backup, you can press the backup schedule button, and a new pop-up window will show up. It is important to know that you can enable or disable this option. It is almost the same setup as the first that we did. The difference is that at the bottom of the prompt, where the schedule field is, you can configure the schedule for the backup to be done. This can be set as daily or weekly at a specific time. You can also set up the backup rotation, which indicates the number of backups to keep before overwriting the oldest. After you have everything set, you must click on the OK button, and you will have your backup scheduled. You will also find the restore schedule option, which you can enable or disable as well. With all these settings, you can restore the information from the last, or from a specific backup, whenever you have a problem with your 3CX console. Then, we have the failover option. Please note that you will need to have the Enterprise Edition for this feature to work properly, but we'll see this feature later on. To finish, we have the location of the backup that you created. If you click on location, this prompt is going to show up. By default, the local disk option is in the location type, but you can choose from the options that you can see on the dropdown. Choose the one that fits better for you. In this case, we are doing it on Google Storage. By clicking on OK button, you will finish the whole setup. Hope you enjoyed this video and see you next time.